means I hope you're all doing well. أتمنى طبعا يكون الميد تيرم كان حليته كويس. عموما هي درجات في ناس جايبة درجات كويسة جدا، فإن شاء الله نمشي كده مع بعض لغاية الفاينل. طبعا unit 2 عندنا is about pharmacy، هنمشي بيها برضو الأول مقدمة. الجزء ده مش موجود في الكتاب، يعني أنا بس عاملة له introduction ليكو. فلس start together. بيقول إن في unit 1 إن الفارماسي ده before years ago fewer people died from heart diseases than they do today because fewer people lived long enough to get it. So major killers in those days were chickenpox, rubella, tuberculosis, meningitis and so on. طبعا بعض الأمراض اللي كان بيسبب وفيات كثيرة جدا قبل ما يحصل لها أو نكتشف لها الفاكسين. Okay. طبعا الـ advances in chemistry and biology along with the pharmaceutical inventions have changed things dramatically. So medicines have turned healthcare from just a practice by which relief may be provided into something more hopeful and scientific. طبعا بدليل على كده الـ COVID-19 والمحاولات اللي بتحاول فيها الـ pharmaceutical companies to find vaccine, find kind of medication or treatment. طبعا اتحولت دلوقتي الـ medicines من بس اللي هو practice for relieving لتخفيف الألم into something more hopeful and scientific. طبعا الكلام ده general بداية الـ unit 2 مش موجود الـ actual words في الكتاب، لكن في أجزاء هقول لكم تذكروها في الامتحان. طبعا الأدوية have defeated a number of infectious diseases. طبعا الأدوية بتعالج أمراض كثيرة جدا جدا معدية، وتعالج كمان ال mental illness الأمراض العقلية، خليتها لها علاج and enabled old age to be active. طبعا ساعدت المرضى كبار السن اللي هم يبقوا أكتر نشاطا. نيجي بقى للجزء ده، الجزء ده مهم قوي، عايزين نعرف كل دواء ويكون العلاج بتاعه بيقدمه ايه للمريض. اول حاجة analgesics. Analgesics to kill pain أو painkiller. Antiarrhythmics. Antiarrhythmics هو to control irregular heartbeat. بيتحكم في ضربات القلب الغير منتظمة. Antibiotics مضادات الحيوية طبعا to fight bacteria. Anticoagulants to prevent blood clotting يمنع تجلط الدم. Antidepressants جاية من depression علشان يقلل من الحالات الاكتئاب أو for changing mood يحسن من المود. Antihistamine to fight allergies بيعالج الحساسية. Antihypertensives to lower blood pressure بيقلل من ارتفاع ضغط الدم. Anti-inflammatories مضادات الالتهابات اللي هي to reduce inflammation. نيجي للجزء ده اللي هو hypoglycemics. Hypoglycemics to lower the level of glucose in the blood بيقلل من نسبة السكر. Immunosuppressive to prevent the body from rejecting organ transplant دي أدوية بتكون مثبتة للمناعة، بتقلل المناعة شوية في حالات مرضية معينة زي مثلا في زرع عضو معين، طبعا بيمنع الجسم من رفض العضو ده. نيجي للaxatives to increase bowel movement. Sedatives to suppress anxiety to reduce anxiety بتقلل القلق. And relax the muscles برضو بتقيم relax the muscles يعني بتخلي العضلات مسترخية. نيجي للفيتامين supplements اللي هي for inadequate diet and digestive disorders. بيستخدم الفيتامين supplements دي لو انت الحمية بتاعتك مش متكاملة وعندك مشاكل في الجهاز الهضمي. Another important point is that doctors and nurses are trained in mathematics to ensure safe working practices with them. أكيد طبعا انتوا هتدرسوها ان شاء الله في المواد الترمز الجاية والسنين الجاية، اذا انت تقدر تحسب الدوزج of tablets او السيربس او الاي في. طبعا بيبقى على اساس الوزن المريض، العمر، الفورمولا نفسها، فدي بس بوينت بتوضح لنا في kind of mathematics in order to ensure safe working practices with your patients. Okay. This writing topic is very important for the final exam. انا مش مطالبه ان انا اشوفه، يعني مش عايزه اشوفه، انا عايزاكم بس تكتبوا فيه، لكن اللي عنده اي مشكله يقدر يتواصل معايا عادي. اللي هو there is a strong argument that says we are becoming dependent on prescription drugs. That is easier to pop a pill when we are ill
then change the lifestyle that makes us that way. طبعا كلنا عارفين ان اللايف ستايل بتاعنا فيه اخطاء كتيره جدا، فمثلا ممكن يكون واحد بيعاني من الاوبيزيتي من السمنه، فيسعى ان هو يروح لدكتور على طول ياخد العلاج بتاعه عن اللي هو يغير اللايف ستايل، في حين اللي هو لو اللايف ستايل اتغير من اكل الفاست فود، من drinking مثلا بيبسي كولا فريز درينكس الحاجات دي كلها الكافيين، ممكن تغير معاه جدا من eating الفاست فود الفاتي فود، لكن احنا بنستسهل دايما و it's easier for us to take kind of medication than changing the lifestyle. ده مثال، برضو مثال ممكن نقوله على الناس اللي عندهم calcium deficiency، الناس اللي عندها hypertension. فطبعا ما حدش بقى يقول لي في اللايف ستايل I wake up early, I brush my teeth, I drink milk، لا انا ما اقصدش كده، انا اقصد اللي احنا نتكلم على ازاي ممكن مرض معين لو غيرنا اللايف ستايل بتاعنا نتحسن الاعراض بتاعته عن اللي احنا ناخد ميديكيشن.
طبعا الجزء ده بيتكلم على testing drugs، ازاي ال drugs are tested before going onto the market firstly. طبعا بيتم اختبار الادوية دي اولا، بيكون على animals، بعد كده بيكون على people. طبعا ده is done on a randomized controlled trial، يعني بيبقى في random allocation of drugs. الكلمة دي مهمة قوي، يعني بيكون ال random allocation of drugs ده اللي احنا ليها مسمى تاني which is called double blind. يعني ايه double blind؟ يعني neither the researcher ولا الريسيرش ولا الباحث ولا الpatient nor the patient know the details of the treatment، محدش فيهم بيعرف تفاصيل العلاج ده. They don't know how is getting the drug, who is getting the drug، مين اللي بياخد الدرج، and who is getting a harmless substitute. يعني بيكون فيه زي كده بتقول ايه، دواء بجد ودواء مش بجد، او بيكون harmless substitute. This is done because it's common for the simple administering of treatment to cure the placebo effect. Okay. فاحنا هنركز بس نبقى عارفين يعني ايه مصطلح randomized control trial. وان randomized control trials دي هي بتكون فيها random allocation of drug to trial participants in a procedure known as a double blind. يعني ايه double blind؟ يعني ولا researcher ولا patient بيكونوا عارفين اي تفاصيل التريتمنت علشان يتأكدوا من صلاحية الدواء بعد كده. Thank you so much.
In a double blind, neither the researcher nor the patient know the details of the treatment. فعلا كل الكلام ده دلوقتي احنا نقدر نشوفه في موضوع الكوفيد 19، ازاي هم بقى في الابحاث بتكون على patient بياخدوا جرعة حقيقية من الفاكسين، والجزء التاني ما بياخدش الجرعة الحقيقية او بياخد دواء تاني، وفي نفس الوقت الريسيرشر والبيشنت both of them are not aware of the right vaccine. They don't know who is getting the drug and who is getting the harmless substitute. This is done because it is common for the simple administering of treatment to cure the placebo effect. يبقى placebo effect نقصد بيه علشان مفيش حد من المريض ولا من الدكتور يتأثر او يكون عنده نتيجة مسبقة او اي شيء، لا هما الاتنين مش عارفين فين الجرعة الحقيقية وفين الهارملي سبسيد البديل اللي هو مش مضر، وبالتالي بيطبقوه على المرضى بتاعهم. طبعا دي introduction كلها في على unit 1. بالنسبة لunit sorry unit 2 I'm sorry، بالنسبة لunit 2 أنا عندي أول part من page 19 till page الأول جزء في page 24 ده self study، يعني حاولوا تحلوه مع يعني prepare yourself كده وحاولوا تقروها، مش هتيجي في الامتحان بس مجرد practice، لكن احنا ان شاء الله هنشتغل بقى من اول page 24 drugstore and pharmacist. Drugstore and pharmacist. Okay. Our page 24. في lecture الجاية. Okay. Or if you have any question, just contact me. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much. Today we are going to take the rest of unit 2, which is about pharmacy. We will begin from drugstores and pharmacists, page 24. Okay, in page 24, we have a reading passage. It talks about in the United States and Canada, prescription are filled by a pharmacist at a drugstore. طبعا أي كلمة بالبولد is very important. Okay, And sometimes American and Canadian say pharmacy too or chemist. في الباراجراف الثاني بنتكلم عن ان الفارماسيست are highly educated professionals with university degrees that include clinical practical. The total amount of time to become a pharmacist is from 6 to 8 years, and a pharmacist dispenses medication ordered by a doctor. However, he or she also sells over-the-counter medication, هي OTC, اللي هي في page 25. كلمة مهمة قوي. اللي هي OTC, over-the-counter medication, يعني medication اللي ما بتحتاجش prescription from the doctor. A pharmacist are client-focused. They spend a good deal of time in communication with client, teaching and informing them about medications and their safe usage. There are no drugs stored in hospitals. A pharmacy is located within the hospital, and the hospital pharmacist dispense the medication for all patients based on written or verbal order. نيجي في questions بيقول what is the goal of this text؟ لما السؤال بيبقى recurrent في reading comprehension. And what genre do you think it portrayed? Question number two. يبقى question number one, question number two. So let's think together كده. بالنسبة للسؤال الأولاني هيكون طبعا what is the goal of the text? The goal of the text is a social purpose. To inform the reader about drugstores and pharmacists. It also identifies the relationships between the two. Question number two. The reading portrays the factual genre. Factual genre يعني هي مش قصة. ولا هي مثلا story. ولا هي editorial مقالة في جريدة في newspaper. لا. The factual genre يعني information. بتديني information about a certain topic. Okay. For the exercises, page 25. Filled. Filled here. In context, I got my prescription filled at the pharmacy. وعندي another context. My tire was low, so I filled it with more air. فطبعا filled هنا هيكون معناها to resupply or return it to original level. طبعا filled is very important. Okay. طب نيجي لي question 26. Refer to means, طبعا in context, I was referred to the pediatrician after my baby was born. Miss Harris is a teacher, but she prefers to be referred to as Janan. هنا refer to means, the best answer is suggesting a new way or new opinion to be gotten or used. 3 degrees. Doctors have science and medicine degrees from a university. You earn a diploma in high school and a degree in a college or university. So here in this context, or in these cases, degrees can be described as documents of achievement. Dispenses. The psychologist dispenses good advice. The pharmacist dispenses medication and advice. The verb dispenses can best be defined as for, gives out, passes out, or provides. طبعا هنذاكر بقى كل الword expansion تقعدوا تقروها وتذكروها. Okay. يعني عندي هنا في الword expansion for example dispensing optician. Mean that dispensing optician هو person who is licensed to prepare your eyeglasses. هو فني النظارات. عندي مثلا when dispensing medication هنا طبعا مش هيبقى فني النظارات بقى ولا فني أدوية. هنا هتكون verb جاي في present tense continuous اللي هو إيه صرف الأدوية. Providing. She dispensed the medication at the hospital pharmacy, but she told me I can get a refill for my prescription at my local drugstore in a manner A to give. طبعا however هنا is conjunctive adverb. بمعنى ايه طبعا معنى unfortunately للأسف. Okay. أو لكن page 28 عندي over the counter اللي هي اختصارها OTC. OTC هي هنا معناها drugs that don't require a prescription and can be bought freely in a store. Okay. Drugs that don't require a prescription and can be bought freely in the store. تمام كده. الكلمة دي مهمة قوي ونعرف بينها الاختلاف ما بينها وما بين ال drugs that require a prescription. يعني بعض drugs require a prescription but other can simply be bought over the counter. Over the counter يعني without a doctor's prescription, كشف الدكتور أو جودة الدكتور. Okay. Page 28 and 29 حاولوا كده تقروها as a kind of homework يعني, بس أنا مش هستلمه. وعندكم هنا المودل أنسر, يعني حاولوا تعملوه نوع من أنواع البراكتس, تقروها لأنها زي دايلوج between the customer والفارماسيست. تمام كده. وعندنا أسئلة عليها, دي الأنسرز بتاعتها بس الألاية في page 29 و30. تمام, فحاولوا ان انتوا تحلوا, بس تحلوها لوحدكم كنوع من انواع السلف ستادي. اوكي, ودي الانسر هنا. Here في page 30 we have interpreting the reading, برضو ده مفروض انتوا تحلوه, بس انا كاتبه لكم الاجابه. Interpreting the reading simply the dialogue about someone who wants something from another person. They communicate for the purpose of communication. As for the building vocabulary page 30, طبعا الكلمات دي كلها مهمه عشان ما يجي لي choices. اوكي, pharmacist طبعا, pharmacist الانسر بتاعتها دي اللي هو university educated specialist in pharmacology. 2, prescription means an order for a medication that only a doctor or qualified medical, dental or nursing professional can order. And 3, allergic means an abnormal reaction to substance. An abnormal reaction to substance. طبعا نعرف بقى هنا كلمة allergy كنون, allergy كadjective. يعني نحاول نعرفهم عشان أقولي في اختيارات في الامتحان. Okay. 9. What are the signs and symptoms? The mood is green, oozing, throbs, and is sore. كلمات دي كلها هناخدها دلوقتي. It was very important. For page 37. 38 and and the first part is 39. وده هيبقى نهاية اليونت بتاعتنا, مش هديكوا حاجة تاني. اوكي, فهنعرف يعني ايه oozing, throbs and sore. 10, the doctor will clean and cover the wound. لو 10 بيقول لي based on in your own professional knowledge, what treatment will Melinda likely receive from the doctor? She will receive a kind of antibiotic طبعا, and possibly give her a tetanus shot because she stepped on a rusty nail. 11, where is the location of the injury? In the sole of her foot. 12, did you notice that the MOA didn't say hello or good morning? Do you think this is proper etiquette or proper behavior for a health professional? فكرة ان المساعد ما قالش صباح الخير او اهلا وسهلا, ودخل على طول وقال مثلا اسم العيادة أو اسم المستشفى, فإحنا بنقول طبعاً is true لأن هو مش وقته أو هو مش دوره to greet the caller ويحييه أبداً. هو ممكن sound not polite but acceptable answer in health facility by first identifying it by name. فتتكلم تقول مثلاً MTI, تتكلم تقول مثلاً دخيل hospital, تبتدي بالكلام ما مش فاكر أقول صباح الخير إزايك عامل إيه, الكلام ده كله طبعاً إيه ملوش علاقة بالprofessional. بس ممكن it's quite acceptable to say hello or good morning. So let's now move to the vocabulary which is very very important, page 37, 38 and the first part of 39. Okay, so let's start now with page 37, 38 and 39. As for the vocabulary of page 37, number one, the word infected. In context, the wound is infected, it has a green full smelling discharge. B, keep that one clean, you don't want it to get infected. So the best answer here is contaminated with disease producing matter. طبعا نعرفها as a noun, an infection can be spread by poor hand washing practices. B, as a verb in the present tense, every year influenza infects thousands of people. C, nurses, laboratory technicians and doctors must be cautious around the infectious material. Here is an adjective. Number two, sore, as an adjective, I stabbed my little toe on the chair, now it's really sore. My tongue is sore, I bit it, ouch. So the word sore here can be a bit described as causing low level of pain. Three, throbs. In context, I am in love every time I see my boyfriend, my heart throbs. When Mary gets a migraine, she says her head throbs. So the word throbs here best goes as pulses or pulsates. Four, nail. In context, a carpenter uses a nail and a hammer. B, a nail is made of iron. So the best answer is B, a pointed piece of manufactured metal used to connect materials. As for number five, pus, there is a pus coming out of the wound. If you squeeze a boil, pus will pop out. So the word pus here is contaminated fluid discharge that signifies infection. A contaminated fluid discharge that signifies infection. Okay? Okay. By the end of this lecture, now I have covered all the material. I'm not going to give you any other material because I know that circumstances and load of the syllabus, and we're not able to meet face to face. So, yeah, and you have to study the vocabulary I have mentioned in my lectures. You have also to study the just two paragraphs I have already tackled with you. You could have two of them. You could have one from an external topic or one of these topics. The first one is about healthcare, but you have to pay attention about the topic sentence, whether I want you to write about healthcare in Egypt, about problems that face the healthcare sector, or I'm going to ask you about access to healthcare. As for the second topic, we have tackled a lot of ideas related to the idea of the pharmacy, lifestyle. Another important point is the vocabulary. We have a lot of vocabulary. Some of the vocabulary mentioned clearly in the book, some within the lectures, especially lecture about Unit 1 pharmacy. I have mentioned with you the type of medication and the disease that is cured. So I hope that you study well, and inshallah, if you have any question, just send me a message, and see you soon, and best of luck.